Hello guys, Neapple Times here, welcome to a new video, and Apple just released iOS 17.4, so in this video we're gonna see everything that's new. Okay, so this is a pretty weird update because it's at the same time very substantial and very minor. It kind of depends on where in the world you live. So for a bit of context, Apple has been on trial for a few years with the EU, which accused it of monopoly practices. Therefore, in an effort to reduce the power that tech companies have over the EU citizens, the EU has passed the Digital Markets Act, which is basically a bunch of anti-monopoly rules. This act goes in effect March 6th, so that's why Apple has released this update today with a lot of changes to comply with it. So first of all, and probably most crazily, Apple is now obliged to allow for alternative app stores. This means that different companies can have its own app stores and they do not have to pay the fees for the normal Apple app store. That also means that they don't have to comply with the rules that Apple sets to allow apps in its app store. There is also a new business structure for developers that they can opt in, and users are actually able to choose their default app store. There are also a lot of minor changes to allow this, such as a screen time setting that allows parents to choose whether their children can download apps from alternative app stores, or a pop-up that comes up when someone is installing an app that contains malware. App developers can also now choose alternative payment methods other than in-app purchases, and of course those do not have the app store fees that Apple applies to those. Also, since it's now facing competition, Apple has added this welcome screen to the app store saying it's a safe and trusted place to discover amazing apps and games. And the app store is not the only thing that's opening up. In fact, the first time you open Safari after updates, you will get this pop-up prompting you to choose your default web browser. Once you click continue, you will get a list with all of the available browsers, and there you can download the one you want, and when you download it, it will automatically be set as default. Also, third-party banking apps can now access the NFC chip on the iPhone in order to make payments with their own app without having to register for Apple Pay. And users are also able to set their default payment provider from settings. So these were all of the EU-only features, but as I said, there's also more to it that is coming worldwide. So these were all of the EU-specific features, but as I said, there's also a bunch of new features that are coming to users worldwide. The first of those is that Apple is actually allowing streaming game apps. Also in the App Store, the Purchases section has been renamed to Purchase History and now shows everything such as subscription, in-app purchases, and all of that. Then it's that time of the year when we get an iOS update which adds new emoji. This time the new emoji include a mushroom, a lime, a phoenix, a broken chain, and two new faces. One nodding yes and one nodding no. Then regarding messages, there's a couple new features. First of all, Read Message with Siri has now been renamed to Siri Messaging, and it now allows you to choose a language in which you want your messages to be read. This is very good for people like me. I have my Siri in Spanish, but my phone is in English, and I get a lot of messages in English. So it's good that Siri is going to read them in proper English and not the crappy Spanish accent weird English that Siri read them before. Also in messages, there is now a brand new post-quantum cryptographic security protocol. And that does sound super crazy and super futuristic, and it actually kind of is. So apparently some hackers were trying attacks known as Harvest Now, Decrypt Later. What this would do is gather all the information now, and they probably have a code that they can decrypt, but in the future, where quantum computer is more common, they could decrypt all those messages. Well, this new security protocol protects against that. Then there are a few changes for the battery life menu, however, this only applies to the iPhone 15. First of all, there's a new battery health menu, which shows normal for your battery status instead of the number, and also shows information like the date of manufacture and first use, and the cycle count. Then a small change to stolen device protection, that's a feature which debuted with iOS 17.3, and is that now in settings you can choose whether you want it to require security delay always or only when away from familiar locations. When it launched in 17.3, it defaulted to when away from familiar locations. Then a few changes in CarPlay. Now probably all of these changes will not apply to you, except in two instances. First of all, if you have a car that supports dual CarPlay screens. If that is the case, there is now an option to show turn-by-turn directions in the instrument cluster. And then there's a few changes to prepare even more for next generation CarPlay. There is 8 new apps available for CarPlay. These apps are Car Camera, Charge, Climate, Closures, Media, Tire Pressure, and Trips. These are of course functions that cars have integrated in their instruments or in their other screen, but now since with CarPlay you will be able to control the whole car, it makes sense that Apple allowed it to be done from your iPhone. Then there's a couple new features for clock. Yeah, amazing how they can keep innovating on a clock. But this stopwatch now shows up as a live activity on your lock screen and dynamic island, similarly to how the timer does. And there is a new widget that you can add to your home screen. Then in podcasts, the Listen Now tab has been renamed to Home, and that change is also present now in Apple Music. And we get transcripts for podcasts, similarly to how Apple Music has lyrics. Then in the Apple TV app, the How to Watch section now shows up as a list instead of the cards interface that was available before. Then Apple created a new API to allow developers to disable hand gestures in video calls. This hand gesture feature was released with iOS 17, and it consists of, like, if you do different gestures with your hands, it would trigger different effects that would be on the screen. Now that sounds pretty fun if you're FaceTiming your child, but in serious settings it can be kind of awkward. And lastly, the option to say Siri instead of Hey Siri is now available in French, German and Spanish. But yeah, these were pretty much all the changes that are coming to your iPhone in iOS 17.4. To be honest, it's an update where you will not notice many new things at first, because of course it enables new capabilities for developers to do things. Things like the next generation CarPlay and of course these new app stores and everything will take time for developers to do. So as I said, you will not notice a lot of new things at first. But yeah, I think this update was done in order to comply with the EU changes, and we will probably see a bit major changes in 17.5. However, do take into account that Apple is full blast developing the probably biggest iOS update ever, which is iOS 18, which will be introduced in WWDC in June. So all the super crazy major changes will be pushed back to release with iOS 18. But yeah, whatever Apple decides to do, I will be covering it here. So if you don't want to miss any of that, you should consider subscribing. Also, let me know down below in the comments what you think of these changes to allow the new app stores. Are you in the EU? Do you plan to use the new app stores? Are you not in the EU? Do you wish you were able to use them? Let me know in the comments below. Also, this video took a fair amount of work and time to make, so if you liked it and found it helpful, please give it a like. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter and Instagram for other content. But yeah, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.